with the help of another method called test. Test accepts a statement and a callback function. Okay, in that callback function is what you will perform all these things. So how do we do that? Well, again, I have to go back to util.js and then start typing that function test. All right. Again, once again, guys, please don't worry that if you are understanding this code or not, because everything will be done by just the main reason why I'm doing this is because to make sure that it is not some magic, but it is just JavaScript code at the end of the day. Right. Once again, I'm back to test. And this accepts a statement because you need to know what type of test are you doing, right? What check are you exactly performing? So it accepts a value called test, and then the callback function is what you will be performing your checks inside. Okay. So now what you will do is you will try to wrap this up inside a try catch block. Yeah, exactly. Error handling. Perfect. Perfect. We have to use try catch for error handling. And where do you think error might happen in our particular functions? When unexpected results come. Exactly. Perfect. When you are not expecting a value of the result, then you are throwing error, as you can see. So I have to gracefully handle this and let know the user that the test has been passed or the test isn't passed. Okay. So that is what I'm going to do now. I'm just going to have a try catch block here. Right, and then catch that error. And if there is any error, all I'm going to do is just console.error and then pass the error value. All right, not just that, you can have a X mark and then say test failed, and then you can pass the error as well if you want. This is some fancy text, but it's up to you. Now in the try block is where I am going to first console log the statement, like console log. And then this is where I'll put evaluating and then put my statement. Okay. First that is done. And now I have to call this function of callback. Okay. I'll say callback. And then here is where I will pass all of this code. Well, I'll tell you when I come to this file. Okay. So now after this runs successfully, because if this ran successfully, it will obviously not go to the catch block. That is fundamentals, correct? So I can assuredly say that the test has been passed. Test passed. Okay. Is this confusing, guys? What I'm doing is I'm just evaluating the statement. I'm calling the callback function here. And then if there is any error, it will catch that error and then say what exactly is the error. If there is no error, then it will just say test has been passed. Okay, clear people? Now, do not worry about what we are doing exactly here, because all I am doing is just replicating what just does. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll just export this expect function as well as my test function and import them here. Exactly. All right. Now what I will do is I will literally delete all of these guys and then start working in a encapsulated environment. Now, what do I mean by that? Separating our code as two chunks so that those chunks of code won't get interfered with each other. Right. So now what I'll say is I'll just call this test method and then I'll have my statement. All right. I'll just say it should add the numbers correctly. All right. Oh, fine. And then this is where I have my callback. I have my callback function. And then this is where I, and as you can see, immediately I do have these two things called run and debug. It's because I have installed an extension called just. That's why. All right, fine. So this is where I will have the result as add 3 and 4, and then let expected should be 7 And then all I have to do is, I don't have to do any manual checks. I should just say expect, put in my value of result, and then call my toBe function to be the expected value. See how elegant is this now? You do not exactly know what is exactly happening behind the scenes, but this is more user friendly, right? You are testing something inside a block of code, and then you are just saying that whether the result is particularly expecting the same value of whatever it has been evaluated. Let me just copy this and paste it once again at the bottom, and then say that it should subtract the numbers correctly. Now, all I'm doing is I have to just come here, have some subtractable values like 8 and 4, and then the expect value should be 4. Is this syntax clear, people? Does these syntaxes confuse you? Ramanujan, specifically for you guys, any doubts exactly? Please explain the syntax again. Sure. The function accepts two arguments, right? It accepts the particular statement of what exactly should happen. You're just describing what type of test is this. That's why I'm saying it should add the numbers correctly. Normally, this is the convention of how people write tests. They would say what exactly should happen, and they will write it here. The second argument is where the particular testing itself will happen. Okay. The particular testing itself will happen inside the second argument. You will first try to compile the function's result into somewhere, and then you will find the expected result with your original result. That is where I'm saying expect of result to be the expected value. If something crashes here, you don't have to worry at all. That is because you have already handled that error here. And that is why I'm calling that function. Once I call that function, immediately the error will transfer in my catch block, right? So now, fingers crossed, let me try to run it. And as you can see, both of the tests are having the test went well function. But I thought to see this as well. As you can see now, both of the tests are running, and you can see that the first test has failed. Even though the first test has failed, it didn't stop me from running the second test. Now, you can confuse of why these things are happening. Now, I can go here and just have inside my util file and remove the else block here because I don't need any more. So let me just save it and then run it once again. And as you can see, I do have a bug. Oh yeah, that's because I forgot a curly brace. Save it, run it once again. And as you can see, you have two tests evaluating. You can see evaluating, it should add the numbers correctly. X mark, test has failed because the expected value was 7, but I received 4. If you go to the code, I still have that error code here. It should never happen. So this is why tests are good to learn as well as perform. The second test had run successfully. It said evaluating, it should subtract the numbers correctly. Perfect. Now, again, if you do not want this particular ugly error syntax, all you can do is just come here and then say just the error's message. That's it. Instead of the entire error, if you want to just get the error message, you can see that it has even more clinked itself and then showed the text. The text, test has failed. The error message is because expected value is 7, but I received 4. The third one is the test has passed. Sorry, the second one has passed by evaluating the subtractions.